Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning.
Thank you for choosing to be here amidst different concurrent sessions. Thank you for the kind words, Sanita. We were together back in India. Likewise, I have so many of my friends here. Thank you for being here. And also the new faces, no more new faces. We are friends now because we are met now. Right? Alright. The topic for today, as you see on the screen, is what? Digital budgets, a virtual reality in a digital ecosystem for higher education students specifically, or higher education area where we can do something about it. How many of you hear the word digital badges for the first time from the smartphones? Okay, there are a few, and rest of you, you have heard about it before. Okay, good. Now, this is not a new innovation, I would say. Rather, it was there in the minds of people in 2011. And 2013, officially, it was established by agencies to be used. And here we are, 2016. Yet, we have a very little idea about what it is and what it can contribute to especially the higher education students. Let's move on. I come from AIIAS, that is Adventist International Institute of Advanced Studies, and let me take you to some of the places. So for that, I don't have a picture on the screen, but you may close your eyes and look around, and you see AIIAS. That's where I come from, right? Can you imagine where I come from? I come from here. So if you have not seen some pictures, when you go around, you see where I come from, right? Well, originally I'm from India, and there are friends of mine who are from different parts of the world, but we studied together in India. Well, let me take you to this. Digital badges, a disruptive innovation. Now, as you all know, and as you have been hearing many presentations on disruptive innovation, the Christensen definition always, it stays in your mind, right? It accidentally replaces the present, you know, practices. Now, why digital badges a disruptive innovation? If you see, there are many, many institutions and organizations, they are already practicing digital badges, issuing and also accumulating digital badges. As you see over here, Doctorate Branding Institute, 19%, they are using, they say yes for digital badges offerings in their institution. This is not a present survey, this is from 2013. So it is already existing. It has gone into the ways of how things are done in this world. Since most of us are from AIIAS, do we have a digital badge? Let's think about it, right? And let's move on. By the way, this is not an empirical study, so don't expect to have a qualitative or quantitative approach. It's a theoretical study. So you would like to know more about that particular topic over here. Now, we move on. You also see businesses, they use what? 8.5%. They use digital badges. And you'll be wondering what this digital badge is all about. Let's have some patience and we will get to it very soon. And you see in education 8.5% and for technology 97%. Now, there is another record which says what? There are already 34 educational institutions which are using digital badges. So, it is already disruptive. It is already a disruptive innovation. People have started using, but it is an innovation, just an innovation for you and me today. Is there any of you who represent an institution who is using digital badge? Mr. Crowe? Yes, now you see now, right? Your institution, you don't offer digital badge. So here we are to learn and to embrace the digital, disruptive innovation. Digital badges. What are digital badges? Digital badges are an assessment and credentialing mechanism. made visible through online platforms. I believe in the 21st century, we all are engaged using online services, and where we have different platforms where these digital badges are shown and used. Now, these are some of the examples of open badges. When you say open badges, these are not badges given specifically by a particular institution. You may be able to access to various learning possibilities, and once you are done with it, they will offer you a digital badge. And this can be part of your online credentials, like you use LinkedIn's account to show your skills. This will be adding on to such LinkedIn website or any other media as your credential. Now, to see a little bit of background, in late 2011, you see Mozilla, Hashtag, and MacArthur Foundation came together at the center of a broad community of collaborations to produce open technical standard for any organization to create, issue, manage, and verify digital badges. But it came into establishment in March 2013 under Open Badges Infrastructure. Now let's move on to see about what is this digital badge all about.
Learning today happens anywhere and everywhere. It happens in the classroom, on the job, in the community, and online. We can no longer keep learning in one way. Today's social and economic challenges require many of them engages students to keep pace with technological change, teaches 21st century skills, and provides meaningful assessments of our own learning. How do we recognize the value of the way we learn today? What if we use badges? What is a badge? A badge is an online representation of a skill or achievement you earn. They can be used in gaming and online spaces to motivate behavior, recognize achievement, and establish credibility. What if we used badges for learning? Badges can be created and issued by anyone: schools, online spaces, cultural and civic institutions, community and professional organizations, to represent a limitless set of skills, achievements, and knowledge. Badges can be earned by anyone, creating programs or projects, or demonstrating specific knowledge, skills, and abilities. Badges can be shared on websites or blogs, social media profiles, online portfolios, and resumes, leading to real opportunities that connecting with potential collaborators, earn skill credit, or getting a job. But in order to give badges wider credibility and acceptance, a robust badge ecosystem needs to be developed. Much work has already been done in critical areas. Mozilla's Open Badges infrastructure provides the software and technical standard for everyone to earn, issue, and display badges across various contexts. A growing community of badge experts has developed various models of badge systems for anyone to use and adapt. Significant research has been done to provide a base of evidence about the potential of badges. A campaign is underway enlisting employers, colleges and universities, urban school districts, and after-school programs to expand, demand for, and supply of badging opportunities. The promise is to ensure that badges give everyone recognition for the learning that happens anywhere, and also sharing places that matter. So what do badges mean for learning? Badges recognize learning as a lifelong pursuit. For you, badges let us see that learning goes beyond classrooms. Skills like creativity and cooperation and passionate interests are as visible as subjects like math and science. Badges show our learning as more than a collection of test scores and grades, but as learning pathways rich with detail and information. This empowers students to guide their own learning, teachers to better engage students, and colleges to expand their admissions process. Badges continue into adulthood, recognizing the learning that happens in various jobs, interpersonal and professional development opportunities. Badges capture knowledge, skills, and accomplishments not found on resumes. This helps workers transfer learning across different industries, and employers find the unique talents and skill sets in demand. Badges cultivate critical values needed in learning today. They make learning more open, democratic, and transparent. They cultivate deeper and connected learning, where learning happens through sharing. They make learning more adaptable to change and open to innovation. Openness, sharing, innovation. These are the values needed in learning today.
So the clip, it talks about enhancement of your skills through a motivation factor, and that is a digital badge. And this is very appropriate in the 21st century. And as I said, it is not just an innovation, it is a disruptive innovation because it's already in practice. Why here today? Because we are making ourselves aware of such a disruptive innovation so that we can embrace it. Let's go into a little bit of other details. One of the recent economic studies, or some of the studies put together, have identified this paradox. What you see here, employees report a shortage of qualified candidates who possess critical job skills. This is not new, right? Almost everywhere people say job opportunities are less for the graduates. Unfortunately, how many are unemployable? It's not about unemployed, unemployable. We create graduates in higher education institution. How many of the graduates are ready to take up any job? And how will the employers or the recruiters know whether you are ready for such a job? Digital badges is one of the best solutions for the graduates to come up with more credentials identified. You may say, what about e-portfolio? What about the other portfolios that can have all these details? Yes, that's true. But these are simplified versions, and the latest innovative form of giving credential for the skills that students learn, and also for the employers to identify the verified, credible, reliable skill of yours. Well, let's move on. It says higher education providers are producing more graduates than ever before, yet fewer than half of new graduates or employees believe that they are adequately prepared for entry-level positions. Well, digital badges can be a solution in a higher education institution to highlight their skills and credentials that can prepare them to be an employable graduate as they graduate from the institution. And let's go on. It says universities are publicly criticized because what? They struggle to demonstrate to employers and to the public the value of knowledge and skills they develop in their graduates. This is what the literature says. And we need to agree to it, because many a times you self-introspect and see how much skill are you and me in a job setting and what did we learn from our graduate studies. So this is something we need to ponder on. Further, it also says what? The badges can be an important part of the solution to reduce what? Market inefficiencies, increase transparency, establish trusted communication between employers, job seekers, and education providers. So badges are something that will prove you to be a very good graduate when you finish your higher education. I also would like you to go through it in a fast way. It says digital badges include a consistent set of metadata. You may be asking, just by looking at a badge, what do we know? It has a lot of metadata within it. So usually when you have that badge on you, it is not just like a Pathfinder or Scouts badge. You know, when you have a badge, you cannot click on the badge and find out what all you did. You may have to find out online or through the manual what are the things you did to acquire the badge. But when you have your digital badge, as soon as you click on it, it will give all the details. Now what all the details? Let's move on to the next one. It begins with an image. And what is this image? This is what an image is all about. And what are the data it acquires? It has what? Badge name, description, criteria for acquiring it, issuer, evidence, date issued, standards, and tags. It comes with all these details. So the credibility of this badge is much, much higher. If you want to understand as how they are mentioned, actually it is an anatomy. It is part of it. If you see this, you will understand. Right? As I mentioned, these are the details that it needs to have. But these are not incorporated. In a sense, not necessarily everything has to be written over the badge for you to identify. Okay, that will help you get connected and understand more about what it stands for. Now, what are the dynamics of digital badges? It serves as an alternate qualification for lifelong learning. I believe as an educator, we are not preparing our students just for the sake of getting a degree. It's for lifelong learning and also to the experience. And as an Adventist Christian educator, I believe it is an education for eternity. And surfacing, verifying and sharing evidence of achievement, democratizing the process of issuing credit, exposing pathways and providing scaffolding, and supporting ongoing engagement. This is something which I really like about this particular dynamic of digital badge. What is it? It supports the ongoing engagement. Many times we are scholars who would like to give up when things don't go well with us. Especially in terms of publishing, one of my experience with one of the universities from South of the Philippines, for the past 9 months, we are up and down. We are up and down. And it takes at least a month. They will correct something, send you back. You check and send, then they will send you back. At one point of time, you decide, oh, why should I? Let me just leave it. Right? But this digital badge, it already provides you with a caution that you are supposed to get it fully only when you are done, but it keeps supporting you, right? That's one of the dynamics of it. Then developing an effective badge system. How can we go about and develop? Create a badge constellation. Now each one of us, if you can create badge constellation, that will increase your credibility. Map meaning to each badge to the overall badge system. Now you are not going to acquire, now I am talking about open badge system, you are not going to acquire badge from only one institution or one badge issuing platform. You can learn many things from many different places and you will acquire badge. And you can keep making a constellation, making a map around your credibility. And this will give more potential for you and also for your students as they graduate. Identify or develop an assessment strategy. Determine relationship within the system and how learners progress. Design benefits, opportunities and rewards into the system. Address technology consideration. Develop an appropriate graphic design. It simply tells that we, as part of any higher education institution, we can develop this badge issuing system within us, following this process. Now there is something called backpack. Now all of us, we know about backpack, and all of us have one with you, the physical one. This is about online backpack. Okay, if you are part of something called Pathfinders, for those who are aware of it, you know that wherever you go, you try to collect some souvenirs from the other clubs. This is something related to scouting. And you try to pin everything over the cap on your back to show the collection of what you have. Now this backpack is an online platform which allows you to collect the badges from wherever you have obtained the credential and you make your own backpack. Now this is visible for all the possible employers of you, in a sense. Now most of you are employed, but when you create graduates, you are helping them to be established for their work life. So backpack can be a best solution for your students to keep building up their digital badges for them. Now, how can you share? This is one of an example that you see over here. Now this particular person, this one is kind of hyperlinked. Okay? It says who's who. Now what is this all about? Now this is a particular credential that he has earned as a digital badge. So when you see this and click on it, it will take you to that badge and shows the skills that you have earned. Maybe one more example. This is another one. And you see this is the digital badge earned by this particular person for that particular experience. Now you in LinkedIn or any other places, we keep adding our experiences. And we allow the employers to go for what? Vetting process, right? The employers have to, especially the human resource trying to hire you, they are going to find out the details whether you have really done or not. Now, badges will slow down, or maybe I should not say slow down, it may take away that possibility of checking for you, because it's already, you know, it's already made sure that you have done it. So digital badge is an additional asset that can be helpful for you and also for your graduates. Now, there are many badges issuing platforms. I would like to list down 18 of them, and if you are interested, maybe later on you can look into it, starting from Acclaim to Utopia, not Zootopia. Okay, you got 18 of them. Now, these are different badges issuing platforms, and they issue badges. However, it is not simply that you go over there and get a badge. You need to follow their procedures, and you need to fulfill their requirements, show some evidence, and they will issue badge for it. Now, important consideration that still remain in 2016. What is it? Problems with identity verification, and there is ongoing validation and management. Now, how do we look into it? What is the identity management? Who is issuing this? Because there are n number of entities in this world, and you suddenly you see a badge in your resume, and you do not know who gave this. Or the employer may not know, is it a credible badge that you have? Then lifelong commitment to managing learner accounts. Then credential requirements change over time. Employers need to trust the validity of credentials claimed by candidates. Now, these are some of the challenges that still remain. However, the badge system, if it is going to be implemented at an institutional level, there may be few special considerations regarding the administration of badges. Now, as I have told you some of the challenges and problems, if you are planning to go ahead by giving digital badges, these are some of the things that you need to consider. What? Who has the ability to create new badges? Not everyone in an institution can create. In a sense, are you producing a skill or competency among your student? For example, if you are a professor in the Department of Business, towards the end of the course, you are required to have your student develop certain skills. Am I right? Because every institution has a bulletin in which it says these are the courses for the student to develop these skills and competencies. How are you going to show it? Now, as a teacher, I think one of my friends right now is concentrating on developing e-portfolio for showing the credentials and skills. And now these digital badges are a little higher version in terms of identifying it and also making the student having it in his resume in a very smaller, shorter, and maybe in an animated form. Okay? Now, who can issue a badge? Because you are a professor, that doesn't mean you can issue a badge. It's just like you give a grade to the student, but it doesn't come from you. Of course, it comes from you. You go to the registrar's office, and the registrar will be the one to give you the grade. Likewise, every educational institution will have a central system through which the badges are issued. Who verifies achievement if evidence is required? Okay, you need to have potential people who is behind issuing the badge to give evidence. Will all badges be public and shareable, or will some badges stay within an institutionally controlled system, either open or closed? Again, this opens up to opens up for a consideration that there are certain digital badges that we can consider for a closed community. You may be wondering why. There are reasons of certain things that you would not like the whole world to know. But there are certain skills you want to hold on your trumpet and blow into the world. I'm not talking about bragging, it's talking about online presence. Right? You would like the whole world to know where you are, what you are doing, what are you worth of. But there are certain credentials you would like to humbly keep it among yourself. So you have your open and closed ones. Well, let's move on. College issue badges respond to the challenges. How the colleges are responding to some of the challenges that we mentioned earlier. What does it say? An ecosystem built around secure, documented achievements conferred by verified issuing organization managed and controlled by learners can be an equivalent solution to that problem. What does it mean by that? If we know what we are doing by having enough documents to support when you offer a badge, it will not be a problem at all. So you need to consider this disruptive innovation in places like Asia, because the first statistics that I showed you is all in the United States of America. Alright? And someone told me that we are always 5 years behind US. Why this has to go on, right? We can also catch up. Maybe we can do much more better. And this is one of the wonderful disruptive innovation for you. Now, if you see there, it says what? Accredited higher education institutions already possess significant advantages. What do you mean by that? Accredited higher education institutions already possess significant advantages. Now, when an accreditation process goes on in an institution, now most of you know from chair, from past school, from there are different accrediting agencies which come to institution and check for various documents, and one of the areas they check is this. What is it that your graduates are coming up with from each course they learn? They look into your curriculum mapping, they look into how your classes are framed, your course outline, your syllabus and everything. But what is going to be something that you can show the accrediting agencies that the students are acquiring by the courses they learn here? And also, what are you offering? It's not necessary every student have to acquire, but that is your intention, right? As a teacher, you want the student to get maximum skills and credentials by the end of completing the course. And this helps, and this is identified as a significant factor even by accrediting bodies. Now we move on. Learning by design is the first step. Success in college to careers. Okay, that we all know, right? We should have a good rate of having the students acquire employable rate. Is there any college administrators here? Okay, maybe not. If you are here, this is for you to know. Every year, you will be following up with your alumni and find out where they are, what they are doing. And you will be proud to tell the prospective students, look at our graduates, where they are now. They are the products of our institution. Right? And this is one of the best platforms that you can think of and embrace it. Right? And think about it and move on. Articulating benefits from general education to extracurricular activities, alignment with education reform movements around credit validation, putting learners in charge. You are helping your learners to acquire this digital badge. Now, being here, why wait? Right? Have your first digital badge. And this is the digital badge for you, attending over here. But how can you access it? We will talk about it later since the time ran out. Thank you for coming over here and listening.